What's the position? We're about equal. Equally far away in both directions. Building a lot, probably not saving to fuck me. Just kidding, saving to fuck me. His builder is so far away, he's fucked. He's actually probably just dead. Catching up. Oh, if he doesn't make an ogre, he's literally completely dead. He might actually be completely dead just from this. It's 9. 10, actually. God, I upgraded for nothing. Fuck. That sucks. That way, that's generally considered cheating. Good players will ostracize you if you do that, because it's not really in the spirit of the game. It's also very hard to execute in a way that, like, it's also, it's counterable. Like, it's possible to do it in a way that is good, but it's also very risky. So it's not, like, completely broken. But the combination of the fact that people will hate you if you do it, and the fact that it's not that easy to pull off effectively in a way that makes sense, keeps people from doing it for the most part. But yeah, that's generally considered cheating. It's also not, it's not easy to do that without fucking yourself up. Like, it's not as easy as you would think to do it in a way that, like, actually helps you win rather than, like, just makes it more difficult. Do I ever not win games? Well, this is my win rate. So I've won like 90% or so of my games. I mean, this is a game that will be close. I can tell you that already. So if you're here to watch me not win, this is a good one to be here for, because I may not win. The shades are all gonna die to the ogres, unfortunately. Yeah, most of them died, but a couple got them. No, I know, but it is a legitimate question, because most people very rarely see me lose. Like, you can sit here for a whole day and not see a single loss, sometimes. But it is less interesting if you feel like the outcome is predetermined every game, and that there's not actually a way for me to lose. I think that would be understandable, whether that is your opinion or not. Well, people actually usually like watching players who win a lot, but it's more interesting if the wins don't feel like they're guaranteed. Which sometimes they do here. Unfortunately. Yeah, I mean, I was a pro StarCraft player. So, like, my RTS mechanics are good compared to most people who play this game. DiaBoLuS, the guy who's number two, was also a Grandmaster level StarCraft player. So, StarCraft community, representing hard in Line Tower Wars. Get through. Nice. That'll at least allow me to pick up one life from DiaBoLuS. Oh, just kidding, he made a 10k cannon. Surprise! He chooses to make his first 10k a cannon rather than an ogre. We need to really need to try to kill this guy to get to DiaBoLuS as soon as possible. DiaBoLuS is gonna get to us soon. Fuck, he made an orb. That's gonna make it a lot harder. Ugh. Feels bad. Okay. Yeah, this game is gonna be hard because this guy is probably going to hold me off for longer than this guy holds DiaBoLuS. Because Arcane is just really hard to break. So our position, which looked potentially advantageous, now does not look so advantageous anymore. Yeah. We're just gonna make the 30k ogre right away. That probably may not have been necessary, but I think it's the safe play. Because it gives me more flexibility to reactively defend the stuff that's actually a threat rather than spend constantly defending the trash that seeps through. That's not what I meant to do. There's gonna be. Probably these are going to go through. That's not the worst thing, though. This is not gonna do shit. Sadly, I think the correct way to kill him is to save, which I don't really want to do, but I feel like I kind of have to. To be honest, it may have been better to stagger those. Yeah, probably was. Fuck. Some of them will still go through, but... Our forces are under attack. Not being able to kill this guy until Griffins would be a real problem. I hope I can kill him around 200k. Under attack. Why would it be such a problem? Because DiaBoLuS, who's my real opponent in this game, is able to put pressure on me, and I'm not able to put any pressure on him. So it's like, he's going to be able to slowly pull ahead if he sends correctly, which so far he's only kind of doing. And it will make it pretty hard for me to win this game. So far, though, it seems like Ben is doing enough to put pressure on DiaBoLuS that he's not pulling ahead of me. Which is good, but surprising as well. Oh, fuck. Gonna get a few lives. So that's the kind of thing that he can do to me while I cannot do anything to him. Fuck, I only got one life. From all those Banshees. You cheer for Ben to win. Unfortunately, it's almost definitely not going to happen. Hello, poison arrow. Oh, he got lives from DiaBoLuS. Fuck. I would have killed him there if not. This should kill him. Yeah, that's not gonna be enough.
Our forces are under attack.
There's no anti-griffin tech. Pretty good for me. Plus 44. Yeah, being between me and DiaBoLuS. Pretty good. This is gonna go down to late game. This is gonna be the first game that I've seen whether my maze is actually beat by these style mazes that DiaBoLuS plays. I believe that his maze style is probably better, but I don't have any proof of that so far. Because I have not actually been challenged like that yet. Damn, these still have the Satyr Aura? Fucking lingers forever. That's a lot of earth. The Archmages are really making those fall short. Alright, I think it's time to stop trying to kill him at this stage. Spamming come up to like 1.5 mil or so. And then give another shot at killing him. Oh, some are getting through. Ah, he's made Voltage now though. First even late game I've played in so long, like really, it's been a really long time since I played an even late game against somebody good. Those loose griffins just get through sometimes. This is gonna be a hard game. Oh my god, I made unstable elemental course. For fuck's sake. Now I have to remorph these all the way from the beginning. How long is this going to go for? Sudden death starts in 7 seconds, so probably about another 3 or 4 minutes. might actually get through, because I didn't have my guarantors up in time. Well, looks like they won't. My hunch is his glyphs at the front are not closely protected enough. But I don't know if that's the play or shredders are the play. Because I'm not completely positive that shredders won't come through. Okay. I have to keep a few A-bombs handy. Alright, I think this is where we start saving.
You have acquired a follower.
We need lives now. Oh, this is so close. Yes, we did it. He can't come back as soon as he starts leaking. Or can he? Yes, we won. Holy fuck, what a game. Oh.